morning. No, that's set up for later. I'm learning fire. I am hopefully finishing the dragon chest. Should probably start with the crown. The crown and all these parts here. Because there's these little sections here that look like they're jewels. That will be different colors. Do I have my true red here? Yes, I do. I have my true red hunter green. Where's my Christmas green? That's glitter. I could have sworn I had a Christmas green. You still over there? You are. One sec. I personally think the Christmas green is closer to emerald. So pretty much emerald, sapphire, and ruby. I should probably choose a fourth. Which one's closer to citrine? Probably depends upon the citrine. It definitely depends upon the citrine. Definitely depends upon the citrine. Some of these are more orange than yellow. A lot of these are more orange than yellow, although it is definitely a lot of yellow. Let's go with the lighter yellow, just so it's definitely more different from the gold. Okay. Wings, I will do the other side later. Let's start with the gold. Witch brush. You have lost your cap. You're smaller than I want right now. Maybe. Yep, let's go with the 3-0. Dealing with paint, I should get my hair out of my face. Just brushed my hair. Why are you being so uncooperative? Come on. There we go. Okay. That's the brush I grabbed. Annoying. Okay, that's part of the skill. might have been the wrong direction. It was probably the wrong direction. Definitely the wrong direction. And now I'm cutting off my head. I'm never gonna get this how I actually want to, am I? So. That's the part that actually touches. So let's get you painted. Figure out to get the part that's actually going to touch the dragon painted and let that dry before I actually get the hinges. Maybe a slightly larger brush. We'll find out. Missed a hair. So, I've been watching the Wheel of Time series. And they've done a pretty good job, it's just also vastly different. Like, the general storyline's the same as the book, but it's also vastly different. I started reading the books. Let's see. Senior, go back to fall 2006. Probably 2003-2004. Before the 11th book came out. Let alone before the original Robert Jordan died. And it's a really good series. They've done a pretty good job. It's just, I'm not sure how they're going to do a lot of things. And they have apparently actually been listening to both Brandon Sanderson, the author that took over after Robert Jordan died, with Robert Jordan's notes. As well as Robert Jordan's editor and wife. So they've apparently actually been listening to them, which is good. Because otherwise they'd probably completely screw it up. Like with the Percy Jackson movies. Those irritate me so much. But so far the show's really good. You just have to treat it. It's a different weaving of the wheel. Like those alternate worlds that you can see through, like with the portal stones. Introduced to those in book two. With my job and all that, I've actually been listening to the Audible, because as much as I like the books, Robert Jordan had the bad tendency of sitting there and taking 5 pages to describe a room, or 5 pages to describe a single chair, and I just kept getting stuck. So the furthest I got was partway through book 11. And then it had been long enough that I couldn't remember much, or at least not enough. So a lot of what I've been listening to, it's like, I forgot about that too. Not the main overarching story, but some of the details. Some of them are important details, but they're still details compared to the main overarching narrative. I love reading the personal physical books. But for some, it's just a lot easier to listen to it. Robert Jordan is one of them. Plus, I now have a job that I'm too busy to actually be physically reading these books, unfortunately. But I can sit there and listen to him. And I won't be stuck reading this page or two, and it's like, am I still reading the same thing? Did I miss something? No, it's still the same thing. But I do highly recommend watching and reading. Or maybe just reading and then watching. Whichever order you want, really. I'm not sure that's dry enough for me to open the box. I haven't decided if I'm going to be painting any silver or copper coins. Well, I might as well do some silver. Because I'm going to be planning on painting the skull silver. So I should probably do at least some silver. I will probably not do the jewels on the back. Maybe all the ones by the dragon's head gold? Most of them, at least. Okay, that is dry. Let's get these hinges painted. Okay, the gold can be the decorative parts of the chest binding. Skull will be silver. Probably gonna make the lock copper. that up. I also changed some of the Tuathuan's backstories. They've changed a lot of characters' backstories. Just enough, probably to help get things over faster. And get through to the audience faster. And some things it actually fits with the character actually slightly better. I'm trying to give absolutely no actual information. There are certain characters that they have not changed their backstory for, which is good. Considering how important that information is for that character in the prophecy of Zahana, of the dragon. You change too much of that character's backstory, the prophecies of the dragon, you're gonna have to change some of the prophecies of the dragon. Some characters' designs and actors are not how I'd imagine they'd be, but they work. Or some of my things, yeah. My ideas of how they looked is actually based off of the covers, as well as the Wheel of Time companion book. And the official portraits and pictures, paintings of each character. I'll say like this one, for instance, Padawan Fane. Didn't exactly look how I expected him to, but at the same time it works, and the actor, as little as we've seen of him so far, looks like he's gonna pull off that character really well. Let's get this crown, because the crown's definitely going to be gold. I looked up the wiki on the Koreathon cycle, also known as the Prophecies of the Dragon. And it's like, this is a lot longer than I thought it was? Because oftentimes they actually only give like bits and pieces. I'm not sure they've actually given the full Koreathon cycle in the books. That might be full in the companion. The show's also proved to emphasize how much I hate the Children of the Light. Or at least the vast majority of them. Trying not to give away spoilers as I've been talking about this. some of the things I've really liked. I like how they've represented Sidene. Also Sidar. Also the taint on Sidene. Nope, you stay open. Silver and my copper. A little too much paint on that brush. The silver seems pretty liquidy. That's good for the silver. Ignore the conversation going on outside my door. I always tend to forget just how orange copper is compared to the other metals. Let's not get paint on myself. This is not a painting shirt. Thank you. Okay. There is a pool of silver here. That looks better. I think I can close that. Okay. I need one of my tiny brushes now. Some of the detail work on the chest. Shut up, phone. I'm not doing this detail work on the back or the other side. It's difficult enough just getting the color I needed over there. Dang it. Okay. My hand slipped. Okay. That side? Yeah, I'm definitely not doing that side. This area behind the crown is going to be bad enough. Too far over. Dang it. There's too much paint on that. Why is the silver so liquidy? This is annoying. Why are you so liquidy? Jeez. Wasn't as obvious when I was doing like the I don't want that much paint on there, not when it's being so weird. When I was doing the coins, probably should have guessed considering how much the spread. Thank you. the silver's being very annoying. Let that dry a bit. Copper's a lot easier to work with. Because it's not trying to run down the... It's so annoying. What time is it? I'm fine for now. The idea for today is to at least get the main colors done. If not the varnishes. Okay. Maybe I can get that a little bit. Okay. That tried to stick a little bit. I think I'll just do the whole chest in gloss. Your ground. Okay. I still need to do the jewels though. Slightly paler than I thought it was, but it should be fine. That's unexpected. Thank you to whoever did that. I'm spilling water. Okay. I'll leave you open in a moment. Oh wait, the crown. How many jewels are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 that can be accessed. A very pale citrine. The emerald. Okay, the jewels are painted. Let's get the inside of the chest done. There's the gloss. Thank you. Gloss went right into the silver. Trying to get the edge. Well, there's less. And that can overlap and end up sticking to each other. Let's see if I can at least finish the front. Okay, got the crown, I got the front, I got the inside. Let's get the other side of these wings. And then we'll be done for today. The rest is just pretty much making sure I get this varnished, the rest of it. There, move these down here. Let's move to the bigger brush. Did I not get all the paint out? Where's that? Okay. So just here so I can actually show you. I know what I'm showing you. What we've got so far. And finally on some of the finishing touches. So, I don't think I really have any announcements. So, Iron Fire, this is almost done. I'll definitely be finishing it next time. Maybe starting something else, because I'm not sure how long this will really take to finish, but it's got to dry before I can close that truly. And, I guess I'll just see you next week, same time. Iron Fire, my dragon is almost done, and I will see you.